गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग। सो इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द डिस्कशन वी आर सपोज टू डिस्कस अबाउट द वोकेशनल एजुकेशन। ओके, because I think that skilled manpower and all those things we have completed. So today we will discuss about the vocational education, and here in this part we are supposed to discuss about the recommendations of Kothari Commission in PE 86 and the revised one in the 92, what they talks about the Kothari Commission, what should be their objectives, implementation strategy, and the assessment plan of the vocational education. However, we don't have here what is the recommendations and the objective of vocational education at a secondary stage as per the NPE 2020, NEP actually, it is a National Education Plan, so, policy, so NEP. So it is not here, but we will also include that in our discussion, because we know that now this document is very much important, because it is now in force as a education plan policy for the India. So we will also include that. So here it is supposed to start the discussion with the importance. Okay, so I think that it is not very much required that what is the importance of vocational education. I think it is not required, because so many times during the discussion in the different sessions we have outlined the importance of vocational education. This is why vocational education is required, that we have outlined. Okay, so their specific discussion is not much required here. Okay, so that I will leave, but we will have a very small discussion by taking your responses, that what you have conceptualized about the vocational education. So may I take your responses? Can anybody say that what you have understood from the term vocational education till now, or what is your conception about the vocational education? What is the vocational education in fact? Can anybody reply?
Sir, main importance of vocational education is to make the person as a earning member of the society.
So to make the earning member of a society. Okay, very good. That is the one of the objective. Santosh ji, are you here? Santosh is not here.
Morning, sir.
Good morning. Yes, so you are traveling somewhere. You are in, I think you are in the auto.
Sir, in my village there are so many auto members are there.
Okay. I thought you are traveling in the auto. So what? What is vocational education, Santosh ji?
Vocational means education by doing.
What by doing?
Sir, education by doing, sir.
Education by doing.
Yes, sir.
That is not a vocational education. That is a kind of experiential education, hands-on. Yes, experience where they will be. No, vocational education is something else than what are you saying.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay, some of the responses are coming in the chat also. I will see later on. So, Umakant, are you here?
Yes, sir.
Good morning. So, what is vocational education? Not, you don't want to say anything, Umakant ji? Achha. Koi baat nahi. Okay, so some of the responses in the chat is that Susmita is saying to prepare an individual, same employed, and also increase productivity of the country. Okay, so that is the outcome. It is, I am interested about the definition of a vocational education. So it is a, it's correct, but it's an outcome, that is to prepare the individual for self-employed. Self-employed is a one aspect. Another aspect is that if I have if I am vocationally trained, so I can go for employment in the some company or some factory or some organization also. It is not always self-employed. And productivity, yes, productivity will increase. Improvement in the skill for money making, yes, it's concerned towards the money making. Thoda sa low grade ka word lagta hai for boliye employment opportunity ke liye, for better livelihood opportunity ke liye. Both are same, but thoda sa ek hai polished word hai, है ना. पॉलिश्ड राइस होता है तो हमको अच्छा लगता है, देन वी परचेज. पॉलिश्ड राइस नहीं होता है तो हम उसको नहीं खरीदते हैं. ओके, नाउअडेज पीपल आर परचेजिंग दैट वन आल्सो बिकॉज ऑफ द हेल्थ कॉन्शियस. श्रीमन मनीष गौतम, टू एम्पावर समवन टू अर्न हिज हर लाइवलीहुड बाय गिविंग सम स्किल एजुकेशन. यस, हिज हर की जगह बोल सकते हैं कि पीपल्स लाइवलीहुड, दियर लाइवलीहुड, ऐसे एक वर्ड होता है. एजुकेशन इज, हाँ हाँ, यस प्लीज
सर. आई थिंक वोकेशनल एजुकेशन इज अ टाइप ऑफ कैरियर एजुकेशन व्हिच हेल्प्स द इंडिविजुअल टू डेवलप स्किल इन ए पर्टिकुलर एरिया.
ओके, अच्छा ठीक है. आई विल टेक योर रिस्पांस आल्सो. फर्स्ट आई एम रीडिंग दिस टेक्स्ट. So education is first priority. Obviously education is a first priority, Jyoti Ranjan, but I am talking here the vocational education. I think Jyoti Ranjan is working somewhere and ek word sun karke he has replied. I don't know.
No sir, I am listening sir.
Oh, then it's a good. Sunanda is saying main purpose of preparing one for employment and occupation. Yes, it's good. We prepare a skill-based education. Yes, it is a skill-based education. Particular skill for particular job. Yes, it is a job-oriented education, of course. Suryakant is saying training in a particular field for earning their living. Okay, so I am not denying that whatever you have told is wrong or incorrect. It's all correct. But it was not pinpointed or focused, because my focused question was related to the definition of a vocational education. So when we talk about, yes, you want to say something?
Sir, vocational education is a technique.
Achha.
Technique to specify some special work, like the craft, and this education, through this education individually earn some money.
Okay, yes, obviously earn the money. Okay, so thank you Priyanka, you are also correct. I think now what I should tell that I will define the vocational education in very much structured way. Okay, because your definitions are also near by the accurate one, and whatever the Priyanka told, she is also very much correct. So the point I want to say that when we try to define the vocational education, it is a kind of education, it is a type of education which is focused towards the skill development, hai na. Because in the vocational education, yes, It is focused towards the providing a better livelihood opportunity for better employment opportunity to become the productive part of the society. Yes, productive part of the society we can become by getting the education, that is the normal and a general education also. We can have a employment opportunity and the productivity when we get a general education also, like a BA, BSc, MA, MSc, like that. But when we talk about the vocational education, it is a kind of education, it is a type of education which is focused towards a developing particular skill related to particular work. It is a focus towards the development of a skill required for discharging particular work. Like that, when I am imparting a vocational education in food preservation, like that the food preservation we have in our B.Ed. curriculum also. Some of you have may have had the during your B.Ed. time also, like a food preservation, tailoring, weaving, agriculture, like that. So, this is the skill development program. So, skill during this program, what we are doing, we are trying to develop a skill related to that particular work, like a food preservation. So, the skill related to the food preservation industry, or like the tailoring. So, skill development related to the tailoring work. Okay. So, when we talk about the vocational education, it is the focused education for development of a skill. Here, the main focus is the skill development. Okay. But there will be also a focus towards the conceptual understanding related to the work, because conceptual understanding is a one part, and the skill, that is the related to the motor skills. When we see the Bloom taxonomy, the three type of a domain is there, the affective, cognitive and the psychomotor. So, when we talk about the knowledge related to that is the cognitive domain. Attitude in being the industry is the affective domain. But that these two will be not sufficient enough. I am very much interested to be in a food preservation industry. I have all the knowledge how to prepare chocolates, how to prepare pickles and all those things. But I don't have a skill. I know theoretically, but theoretical knowledge will not be sufficient enough. So, if I don't know how to prepare a pickle, I don't have a hands-on experience, then it won't be very much appropriate and I won't be very much suited in that industry. So, when we talk about the vocational education, it is the skill development. It is more focused toward the skill development. And of course, as a result of that, we will have a better employment opportunity that you have expressed is a correct. I will have a better earning opportunity. I will be a productive member. All are correct. Okay. So, today in this session, we will try to see that what NEP 2020 says about the vocational education. And why I am starting from here? The one thing is that this one is the latest one. So, that is the one thing, but that is not a deciding factor. Other policies talks about the vocational education, vocational skill development as a separate kind of a thing, or it should be integrated at some stage of education, like that the NEP 1986 and the revised one in the 92. They talks that the organization of a vocational program as a separate program or at a secondary school education. Like that, the earlier conception is there. But this document identifies that organizing it separately, and I am also very much convinced with that. Sometimes with something I am not very much convinced, but with this philosophy and this logic, I am also very much convinced. Because as I was talking just few minutes back, that for being in a vocation, in a profession, okay, three things are required. That one is the cognitive domain, that is the knowledge about that. Another one is the psychomotor domain, means the hands-on experience, skill, because the skill will not come with the cognitive domain by knowing the thing. Skill will not come. Skill will come when you will have a hands-on experience. And these two things are also not sufficient unless or until I have an attitude. So these three things are essential. All the three things are essential. I have a skill also. I have a knowledge also, because I have been taught in the school, but I don't have attitude. I see some work as an inferior work. Like that, when we get education, we used to say that, so I am M.Ed, I am a PhD degree, so why I will go for the agricultural work? Or why I will go for the some other work, carpentry or some other thing? Why I will go? Because I am highly educated. Because I don't have a positive attitudes towards those profession, those vocation, and I find them as a inferior to this. Suppose that I am a teacher now. So if I find that those professions are inferior than the teaching profession. I have found someone that I have interacted with some people that they find that after doing a graduation or doing a post graduation or a B.Ed. M.Ed., I have told they were not able to get the job somewhere. So I told, why not you open the coaching institute? No. So, main B.Ed. M.Ed. karke coaching karne ke liye padha hun. So the point of saying is that they find it inferior. So all the three things are very much required, and this policy document talks about development of all those three things: cognitive, affective, psychomotor. And that's why I am very much convinced, and that's why I have started with this document. And that's why this document talks about that the vocational education should not be organized at a particular stage of education, like a secondary education or a senior secondary education or like that. But vocational education should be the integral part of the education system, because the ultimate goal of education is to provide a better life. Why we are educating the child? To have a better life, to become a contributing member of the society and a country. So for the better life, cognitive is a one aspect, affective is a one aspect, affective is another aspect, and skill is also another aspect. So that's why I appraise this document, because they said that it should be integral part, and there are certain recommendations and suggestions also that how it will work, that we will be seeing in the detail. So as per the policy 2020 NEP policy, the vocational education should not be organized at a particular level of education, rather than it should be a integral part of the education system. Integral part, not at a particular level. And for the development of attitude also, there are some program that we will be seeing. Okay. So I think the presentation is visible to you, or it will be visible after a few moments.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you for confirming. So, as I was talking about that, this policy document talks that vocational education should not be a part at a particular stage, rather than it should be integrated. Means when the education is starting up to when the education is finishing. Education never finished, but the formal structure like up to the higher education. So, from the school education to the higher education, the component of a vocational education will be there. And we know that the vocational education prepares a individual for the work, as I was talking when I was trying to define the vocational education. It is the focused education to inculcate some of the skill required for the particular work. And obviously, it prepares a people for the specific occupation. As I was giving the example of a carpentry or a food preservators. So, the skill developed as a food preservators will prepare them for the industry or occupation as a food preservators. Okay. So, in nutshell, as I have defined, that vocational education integrates a complex knowledge, attitude and a skill for particular occupation. Knowledge is the cognitive, attitudes is affective, skill is a psychomotor. Then when this document is suggesting, because this document is suggesting that there either is a need of integrating vocational education in the education system, not at a particular stage, but in the education system. So, before recommending, they have some data, means they are supporting their logic with the data. Why they are recommending that vocational education should be imbibed, integrated in the whole education system? One of the logic they give that that we have seen in the previous slide, that we require a specific people with a specific skill for a specific occupation. Those who have a skill, attitude and a knowledge, all the three are required. And somewhere during our previous effort, we failed in that. That's why when you will go through this document recognizes the effort made by the previous policies, that is the policy of 92, 86 and 68. But it also say that there was somewhere the lacuna. And that's why the Indian workforce in the age group in 19 to 25 is 5% trained from the formal vocational education. 19 to 24 is the age group of a student in a higher education. So those who are in the higher education, the total population, so 5% of the total population in the age group of 9 to 24 are trained with the formal vocational education. And why they are giving this age group? because when the children enters into the higher education, they are coming out of the school education, that is from the senior secondary or a higher secondary or a plus two education. So when the moment they finish the plus two education, at that time only 5% of the children have received formal vocational education, means the rest 95%, it is in less than 5%. So you can say that the more than 95% are unfit, are not able, not capable for any professional or a vocational occupations or a vocational industry, because they don't know. They are not suitable for the food preservation industry, they are not suitable for the tailoring, they are not suitable for the agriculture, electrician. So they are not suitable, and that's why there is a point of, there is a matter of unemployability and the less opportunity of employment, because they are not, they don't have a skill related to any vocation. Whereas when we see some of the developed country, the USA have a 52%, Germany have a 75%, South Korea have a 96%. These whole data has I have taken from the NEP. It is given in the NEP 2020 document. I have taken from there only. Okay. So this statistics actually explains why there is a immediate attention towards the vocational education. Okay. And when we see the time frame of implementation of this NEP 2020, they have targeted that by the end of year 2025, means after 5 years, they have a target to provide vocational education access to the vocational education at least 50% of a learner. Okay, 50% of a learner will be exposed to the vocational education by 25. This is the target the government has set out. Now we will see the some of the recommendations. See, they have come up with the data that what is the status. They have also outlined that in this situation, what kind of strategy they must have, that is the integration of a vocational education at all level of education. Okay, and that's why they recommend that vocational education will be integral part of a school education and a higher education. It won't be separated. So there must be some component at a every grade, and by the end, means during the grade 9 to 12, by end of the senior secondary, actually as per this policy there is a no word now as a senior secondary. So by the end of a secondary education, a student will receive at least one vocational education. In any vocational education, at least you will be trained. So when you will come out of the secondary education, you will have some skill, so that as per your interest, need and demand, you can pursue the vocational education and you can join that. Okay, and there is a also the scope of, because I was talking about that this policy document talks about the all the three domains: skill, that will be developed by exposing the student to the hands-on experiences, cognitive by orienting them theoretically about the profession, and for the attitudinal development, two programs are there. One program is that since it will be integral part, so all the student will be learning about all the vocation. So there will be no, or there will be minimized feeling of inferiority or a superiority about any vocation. Suppose that we have an inferiority about the agriculture, but all the students are learning doing the agricultural practices, so there will be minimized form. Or a carpentry, so all the people will be doing. Second thing is that it also has a provision of sending the student to some vocational site like a carpentry, blacksmith, electrician, shop of electrician, agricultural field for 1 week, and that will be the bagless, it says that, during the grade 6 to 8, so that the attitudinal change and the development of feelings, affective domain related to the vocation will be developed. So, and whatever the vocational input we will have, it will be based upon the Indian cultural ethos, or it will be integrated to the co-curricular activities in science, arts and sports. And also to have a trained teacher, because there will be one vocational teacher, but other teacher also are also required to have a some sort of a idea related to some of the vocations. So to do that, the vocational training part will be also included in the pre-service teacher training program. Like that, you are a teacher educator, pre-service teacher educator, but the B.Ed is a pre-service teacher education program. So that will also have a component, and those who are the teacher, they will be also have a in-service teacher training program with the help of BIETS or a DIETS, Block Institute of a Teacher Education, and a DIETS is a District Institute of a Teacher Education. Education training. Or by calling any local person, those who are expert in that. Suppose that I stay where lots of farmers are there. So I will call some of the farmer to give a talk on that. So by that, the skill, cognitive part, skill part and the attitudinal part will be taken care. Okay, so I will just finish these two slides more are there, and then we will have a question answer session. So now they talk about that how it will be implemented, because they have given a vision, they have talked why it is required, but how it will be, that is also the important part. One of the important thing that I was saying, that those who are a locally available person in any vocation, they will be brought to the school, and the program name is a Lok Vidya. Lok Vidya. So the local artist as a master instructor in the school, they will be brought out. Even the NIOS, National Institute of Open Schooling, they will be also encouraged to have a vocational courses. Okay, even the vocational skill development will be also a part of a adult skill development curriculum. So that will be also a part of that. Even the higher education institute, they will also contribute in the vocational education development by supplementing the hands-on training to the student, because it is integrated throughout the education. And for development of a curriculum, NCERT will be and SCERT will be given a responsibility for development of a vocational education curriculum. And in fact, NCERT has developed, because you must be knowing that NCERT have a RIE, that is the 5 RIE we have till now. Apart from that, they have also one constituent unit, that is the Pandit Sundar Lal Sarma Central Institute of Vocational Education. It is in Bhopal. So NCERT with PSSCIV and SCERT through the State Institute of Vocational Education, where they are existing, they will develop a curriculum. And in fact, till now NCERT has come up with a vocational curriculum for several courses, several vocational education programs. So that will be there, and it will be improvised also. This slide directly I have taken from the website of Ministry of Education. It is the part of a presentation for the NEP 2020. For development of a curriculum, there will be Lok Vidya, as I have told you, where the local people will be brought out. There will be practice based curriculum developed for 6 to 8, when they will go to visit the vocational sites. There will be a skill development framework also, and the skill gap analysis will be also done, that what kind of a required skill was there and what kind of a skill they have, what is the gap and what there should be developed. ODL mode will be also there, that I have told, that the NIOS, National Institute of Open Schooling, they will be also encouraged to have a vocational education in their program. And there will be a bagless program for a student of a 6 to 8, when they will be sent to the vocational sites. Okay, so that was all about what NEP talks about vocational education. Okay, so that was all about. Now we will have a discussion session, question answer session.
Sir, I am Umakant. Sir, sorry, I could not answer the last question, sir, you have asked. Actually, I had a little doubt, sir.
But you have replied in. You have replied in the.
I am sharing confusion. Sir, actually, my question is, how vocational education is different from professional education, and the occupation, particular word occupation, how occupation is related to vocation and profession. And the third one is teacher training program. Why teacher training program is professional, why it is not vocational?
Okay, I think when I will outline the difference between the vocational and a professional, so most of your queries will be sorted out, because why teacher education program is a professional, not vocational. So once you will understand the difference, I think you will be able to understand. So see, first, what is the similarity I will talk? The similarity is that both are designed and organized for providing a better employment opportunity, for making them a contributive member of the society. Both are focused on that. But there is a very baseline difference. When we talk about the vocational education, so here our focus towards those occupations or those work, not occupation, I will talk the work, occupational work. Occupational work means by which we earn our livelihood. Okay, so vocational education is focused towards those occupational work which are very generic and available in the society. Like that, when we talk about the carpentry, it is a very generic work and it is already available in the society, means a different section of a people, different section of a population, they have it, they have this kind of a work for their livelihood. Like a blacksmith, it is existing and a different section of a society are using that, they are relying on that for their livelihood. Like a agriculture, okay, like the work related to the leather, like the work related to the making pots, earthen pot, pottery. So these work are very generic in the society, which are being done by the people for their survival since a long time. Pottery is not a new concept, not a new thing even. I think since the human civilization, when they have learned that how we can make a pot out of the mud, so it is continuing till now and it will be continuing. Like a furniture making, it's a very generic kind of work. So the occupations related to that, we term it as a vocation. And why we focus on a vocation, that also I will talk as a supplementary. But when we talk about the profession, professional work are not that much generic and existing. Like that, when we talk about the teacher education, teaching was there in the society since the civilization of a human, but a structured teacher preparation program was not there. You remember the time of Mahabharata and the Ramayana, and those time teaching profession was there, teaching was there, but teacher preparation program was not there. Teacher educator program was not there, means how to prepare a teacher. You are at a B.Ed. level, so you are in a teacher preparation program, teacher educators you will be. So how to train a teacher, that program was not there. Teacher training program was not there, structure type, it was not there. When we talk about the engineering is a profession, medical as a profession, because it was not there. It is a new kind of a thing, one thing. Another thing is that when we talk about the vocation, here very concrete concerned cognitive input is there related to that, means cognitive input related to that work only. But generally when we talk about the profession, means the course related to the profession, it is a interdisciplinary in nature. Like for a teaching, teacher education program, we cannot rely on the pedagogy, we cannot rely only on the content, we cannot rely only on the assessment, philosophy, psychology or whatever it is. In order to become a effective and exemplar teacher, knowledge and a skill and attitude towards all the things are required. Like that in a doctor also, like that in the management also, like that in the engineering also, and the others also. Okay, So there is a basic difference, and that's why we term teaching as a profession, not as a vocation. We term carpentry as a vocation, not as a profession. This is the baseline difference. And why we are focusing towards the vocational education? First, come to the professional education. For the professional education, a specialized training program is required because it has a different components, different area. You cannot prepare a teacher by including a teacher, including a component of teacher education throughout the education program. Because for that, suppose that I want to include the component of a teacher education program in a school level. So they may not be cognitively developed to understand the idea. Even when I was in B.Ed., sometime I was finding that I am not cognitively developed to understand the idea when I did. Okay. But for the vocation, since we used to see the things in our day-to-day life, we do also. So here the focus on development of a skill, refined, fine motor skill for that. We used to do, suppose that nowadays you must be seeing a lot of video on a do it yourself, DIY. And we used to do also, our children also used to do for their project work. So they are doing, but by that doing, they cannot be a carpenter. So thoda refinement hoga. So that I am not also saying that whatever the vocational education input is there in the school education or in the that this policy document is talking that throughout the education I will integrate. So don't think that by integrating the vocational education component the children will be fully prepared. Suppose that I have taken a carpentry, so I will become a full carpenter when I will come out of the school. No, but you will have a certain skill, you will have an attitude, you will have a feeling, some knowledge also. You don't think that they will come out as a carpenter, they will come out of a potter, they will come out of the farmer. No, it is not like that. So these are the basic things. I think I am able to address your question.
Yes, sir. Bakal, yes, sir. Thank you very much. Sir.
Question.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you very much.
Okay. So Suryakant is saying training in a particular field for earning. I think it is a previous question. Okay. So is there any question apart from that? Anybody? And I am saying very less attendance now, only 25. So out of 25, one is I am. So 24. Out of 37, 24, it's not sound attendance. Okay. So I think there is no other question. So shall we stop the session here?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you for being with me. Have a nice day.
Thank you.